right there. He's not too happy. He's right in the middle of the road. So that's what we're dealing with today. We hope these boys, we know they're out now. So let's get out here and take a look real quick. We're not gonna be silly today, but just to show you, this is what's out here today. So he was just crossing the street, and there he is. I saw him long, but you know, here's again, his goal is to protect himself, right? And his goal is to make sure that he protects himself, but I saw him coming across that road. But you know, he got me a little freaked out there for a second, but look at him. You know, he's definitely giving us a lot of warning. And they say like 80% of snake bites, maybe even 90, are the error of the person and not the snake. Maybe taunting and things like that. But if you look at him right there, I tell you what, he's ready to go. And he's not a happy guy right now. And you know, he's crossing that road, but you know, they're everywhere. So you gotta make sure. A good shot right there. He is not happy. He'd strike me in a heartbeat. There's no doubt in my mind he would strike me. So that's what you get out here today. So, hey, welcome. Man, I'm glad you could come along with me. You can ride shotgun today. You know, I'm out here today looking for a location. It is one of the largest areas in Agua Fria as far as communities, ancient communities. And I'm looking down here and I'm using, you know, all the visual. Now, I've already Google Earthed this, and I know I'm going to go through a set of ruins. I haven't seen it yet, but the funny thing about out here is you go down through here, right, is you're looking to see if you can find what looks like ruins. And when you get used to, you have that trained eye. Now, if you're using Google Earth, you can see the foundations from above, which makes it awesome. But when you're driving by, you know, you could drive by 100 ruins and not even ever see them. Now, that's a road we're probably going to have to take right there. But I think I'm going to wait till the way back to do it, because I think we got something up on that hill. And but, you know, you can go by here 100 times and not even see any of this stuff. And, you know, you just got to keep your eyes out and then use your, you know, if you want to, you could actually track it onto GPS. But I don't think it's going to be that difficult to see today, because we've been doing this long enough. I think we'll get it. But, you know, you look out here and then what you're doing is you're just scanning. And, you know, usually where would they be? They'd be on a hilltop, right? They'd be on a hilltop. And so do you see anything out there? When you see trees, that shows that there's water. And guess what? They were going to be where the water is. Remember, that's our guide, is where the water is where the ancients are. But, you know, that's what we're doing today, is just is we're driving. We're in Agua Fria, and we're looking for one of the largest ruins that are in this whole monument. And they were very prevalent on Google Earth. We went, you know, we're looking for the first one right off the side of the road, and then now we're going to go to the second one after we get to the first one. And we're going to take a look and see if we can't find it. Okay, so we see a sign up there, right there. You can see the sign. That didn't look that prevalent, but if you're used to this, okay, the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna see a sign up there. So you gotta be aware of your surroundings. So let's get out of the truck real quick so we can kind of show you. Now, I would even drove around this one. So let's get on out of the truck and let's take a look real quick what we got. How beautiful is this out here today? So, I mean, I already know what it is because I know what these signs mean. The sign says that this is a sensitive area and that we need to give it the utmost respect. And we need to stay off the walls because most everything out here has walls. You know, these people didn't become nomadic till later, and they built permanent structures. And so when you see these signs like this right here, you know, you're trained enough to know. And you can also see the vegetation right here. Look at this vegetation. And look how thick it is. So we're in an area that looks like a natural dam, right? Not a natural dam, but a man-made dam right there. How crazy. That looks like the road too. So you can tell that this used to be an area with water because you can see all the vegetation. Another thing we're seeing is we're seeing the shards. We're keeping our eyes out for any type of snakes. Now this is pretty well, you know, one of the disadvantages when you get these so close to the road, like some at the Brooklyn Mine, is that they're too close. And you know, a long time ago, and this wasn't close, you know, these places got ravaged by pot hunters. But again, it was legal till 1960 to do that. So as we're going through here and we're looking around, we're in the middle of another site right out here. Man, the wind's blowing. I hope the mic's pretty well. Hope the mic's good. But we're walking through, and you can tell again by the vegetation. So as we make our way through these stickies, but this is pretty well a devastated area. But you know, would have drove right by it. Now we found our structure, right? Now there's a nice location down there. It's kind of got me interested because again, water flow. So we're looking at water flow. Look how gorgeous that is. Look how beautiful that is. So we found the first, but look how it was just right off the road. And if you didn't know what you were looking at, then guess what? You would have missed it. There's shards all over. And again, snakes love this. They love these ruins. And maybe that might be the ancient trying to protect them. I wouldn't second guess that. Oh, that hurt. I like this little floodplain down here. Very intriguing. I'm going to take a little walk around here. Can you imagine what this would have been like out in the day? I don't know what. Is that a log down there? Burnout log? But we never know what we're going to find, so you know, take your time, smell the roses, look around, because who knows what's up here? You never know what you're going to find on the ground, you know. And look, oh, there's a zillion shards. So these are old locations. It's the backside of the wall right there. Always usually trees. Always looking for rocks that's been worked. They've cut an edge on, but there's shards everywhere. This is an old area. You know, this is not unusual for Agua Fria. Again, that's why they tried to make this, or did make this, a monument. But you look at these area locations and you're looking at for bumps. Bumps on the ground, places there could have been dumps. You know, because ancients had dumps just as well. And you're looking around here to try to see if you can find anything that would give you more indication of the lives. But boy, what a view they had. And this soil here is so much nicer than a lot of the volcanic on the other side of the road coming in. This is actually a joy to walk on and to hike on. Really easy and nice. But we're looking around here. Do you see any other places? I want to say that when we go out, we're going to go up that hill. That'd be a nice area up there also for petroglyphs. And that would be far enough off the road. But, you know, when you see those roads, you know, like I said, one thing, roads in the middle of nowhere go somewhere. Now, they may be in the middle of nowhere, but they go somewhere. So it's always important to make sure that you keep your eyes peeled, because you could be walking right through this stuff and not even see it. Let's go down the road and see what else we've got going. Now, one thing that's really funny as we look around here is I almost drove by this, but, you know, I had the advantage of, I Google Earth this. That's why it's so important to use Google Earth. Now, if you were driving down this road and you didn't know exactly what you were looking for or what the signs are, you might have drove right by this, because one thing I thought was, because this proximity to the road was so close, I figured these ruins would be pretty beat up. But what I'm hoping is because they're so close to the road, but they're so well disguised that most people don't even know it. And you wonder, you know, how many times have you been by stuff? And especially in Arizona, how many times we've been by here, these locations, and we're right there, and we didn't even know that they existed. So one thing I'm going to help you on is this. I knew this was here because of Google Earth. When you get on Google Earth, you can see the foundations, you can see the walls. And even though if you looked out here, you know, you wouldn't maybe even know what that is. Just looks like a mound, right? But because we have found a few locations, right? Now, what I'm looking for today, and this is just a part of it, is one of the largest structures or communities in Agua Fria. Now, again, one thing we're going to be careful of is the snakes are out. We're going to hit triple digits here at the end of the week, and that means that you better have your water ready, and you better be prepared, because the last thing you want to do is get out here and get yourself in trouble. Now, to the untrained eye, that just looks like brush, right? Look at this. But if you've done this a few times, you start to see the walls. You also see that there's a lot of vegetation that usually grows up around these. So when you see these, you know, automatically when you've done this a few times, is you start to go, okay. Now, on Google Earth, I can see these pretty prominent. And here they are, right here. So here are the walls. Now, that's a pretty good wall right there. So we're going to walk through here and take a look. Now, this is one of the smaller structures that we're looking for. But look at that right there. That is a beauty right there. What a beautiful place it would have been to have been up on this hill, you know. And look how gorgeous this is. And these walls are still pretty well intact. I mean, it's not bad considering the proximity to the road. I mean, these are as good a shape as a lot of them that are a lot deeper in. And this was a pretty good-sized structure right here. Now, there's some mounds down below that also have a look of whether they be prehistoric dumps or some type of maybe burial sites, something like that. Now, one other thing I'm looking at as I'm going through here is how some of the stuff, when you start to see it, you notice that it is something, and you didn't know that before. So you start to look in here, and you start to see this, and you start to realize that these mounds down below, those weren't natural. Now, what I'm seeing here is a lot of rock. So they either had a large wall around this complex, or this was a massive wall at one time. Now, you can see how as we go through here, as the structure walks down through, you can really tell that they had a lot of stuff going on here. This was actually a pretty good-sized structure. We're careful to stay off the walls. We're careful to make sure that we're looking out for snakes. They love ruins. They absolutely love ruins. So we're going to definitely be careful about that, especially this time of the year. And if you got gators, it wouldn't be a bad thing. I don't hike gators, but I'm not saying that that's dumb by no means. Now, one thing you do want to make sure that you're doing is you're making a lot of noise. So this was a good-sized structure right here as we look down here. and look down below. But what a beautiful valley. How cool would that have been if the water would have been flowing? Now here's another, you know, they still built on areas where there wasn't any rocks to be able to put any petroglyphs. So did that make a difference? Did that make a difference? Now, right here, let's take a look. And what we're gonna do is, even if you can't see this, there are shards everywhere. This is an old location. They've been here for a long, long time. There's shards all over, pretty primitive shards, but they're here. And then we'll leave them here. But you can see these mounds, those aren't natural. And then you can also see these places where they had fires. This scorched the earth. So, one thing you need to do is really take a look when you're out here, really study this. So even if you can't get out here, what you want to do when you watch these videos, and I'll try to give you a lot of footage to be able to do that, really look at the different locations and do you see something out there? Do you see anything? You know, here's a funny thing too is, look at that road right there that goes up. Where does that go? Now there's rocks up there. Could those be petroglyphs on that ridge line right up there? Absolutely. And you know, roads usually go somewhere. Now I would tell you up on top of that ridge, those kind of look like ruins. So we're gonna probably go over there and take a look, but we're still looking for the large structure. Now I think this goes to an old mining community, but we're gonna take a look and see if maybe, you know, there's some faint roads over there also. But in this location and in this area, there's ruins everywhere. You know, look what we found. There's an old concrete structure up there, and it looks like this area, there used to be a mine back here. So let's go out and take a look. I mean, it looks like they were mining on that hill. And then as we come through here, here's an old structure right here. You know, I love coming out here to these places. It's just so funny when you find ruins, then you find mining and you find all kinds of stuff. Now I'm not sure. Something just popped. Oh, my glass. Whew. I heard that pop and I didn't know if it was a gun or not. I mean, I'm pretty well out here. Now, we have seen people out here today. So, this the old homestead right here. Look at that thing. Very interesting. And I don't know what that concrete thing is over there. That, you know, we're gonna have to go take a look at that. There's just no doubt. Now, there used to be structures over here, you can tell, but look at this. Is this the old mine house? Look at that. How cool is that? It's the old fireplace. Wow. Look at this thing. Wow, how neat is that? Look at that. Isn't that cool? So we know we got a mining area right here. We know that for sure. This is the old house. Man, get a weird vibe. There's a lot more to this than I'm seeing. So what we're gonna do is, let's take a look at that concrete structure up there. What could that be? I'm not even sure. And then let's see what else is here. Looks like there was an old trail, a lot of old glass bottles, stuff like that. And there is a little water running, not a lot. This would not have been an easy life. Would not have been easy. But take a look at this. I think it's cool that the creek's still running. That's pretty awesome. Wonder where there's an easy way. I guess that could be the trail right there. You want to take that one? You got to climb that hill with me, so you might as well. Make the same decision I am. So, isn't that neat? Well, we're not going to die of water without water today. That is awesome. So at least water's not going to be our issue. So let's take this trail up here and see what we run into up here. You know, what's everybody think that is? You know, I tell you what, the amount of work that would have taken to put that in, you can tell where there's areas where they're leveled, where they had maybe some type of other machinery. Just amazed me how they all of a sudden, this could have been a stamp up here. Look at this. Look at the work that would have taken. Look at all this up here. Isn't that incredible? Wow. This is incredible. That's a hell of a nice structure that somebody put in here. You know, what always amazed me is, you know, look where we're at. Just take a shot there. And, you know, I know there's a lot of mines and a lot of more difficult places. Looky here. That's pretty cool. There we are right there. So it had to be coming out of that ground up there. Now let's take a look in here. Oh, we got hornets. We got wasps in there, not bees this time. We got a wasp nest. I'm not going to go any farther. I will send you guys in, though. You okay with going in? Well, you see anything? Don't let it sting you. Whatever you do. It's a nice wall. They did nice work when they put this structure in here. Wow. Just always intrigued me. And then you look right over here, that looks like, almost looks like ruins right there. I don't think it is, but that's that, those clumps that you get when you get ruins. Well, we've made it up to the top and we're getting ready to cross this little peak right here. And let's go up here and see what's up here. What do you guys think it is? You think it's a shaft? Think it's a mine shaft? I don't know. I'm guessing yes, but who knows? Well, it wasn't like I thought. I thought it was going to be an empty hole right here. And it is not. Definitely dug out. Now, these are areas you definitely want to make sure that you keep an eye out. Because this came out of the ground somewhere. Where that area is, I'm not positive, but it came out somewhere. That almost looks like it sunk in, like they were digging here. Hard to tell though. Let's go down this end and see if there's any. Looks like they had definitely had a pole around this area. So if we absolutely disappear in the middle of a abyss, you'll know what happened. But you know, here's another thing when you think about this. You know, it takes you a long time in a car or a four-wheel drive. Takes you a long time to get here. And I can only imagine all their product would have been shipped out of here. And man, That'd have been a difficult deal, just getting the stuff out of here. I mean, man, look at these flowers. Isn't this crazy? I think if I break out in the hills or live with the sound of music, you know, don't even think anything. Don't turn off. Just know that I'll have come to my senses eventually. But man, if I ain't at Julie Andrews' house right now, I don't know where the hell I'm at. Look at that. That's crazy. There's a mine right there. See, you get up here and you take a look and you start seeing some of this stuff and you're like, man, there's stuff right there. You know, one thing I love about these old places like this is here's a little bit of a dump of something. Right here. Trash can. So this was a dump in this area. I stumbled on. And then that's an old car hood right there. But I'm thinking, man, maybe I'm not. Maybe it's not. Thought it was. It was cooler than I thought it was. But I love these old parts. Let's take a ride on down the road. Here's where we were. Up on top. See where that dirt mound is. Plenty of water. Let's get plenty of water. First blood of the day. When it hit me, I was like, dang it. I knew better. I knew better than that. But it's the desert. And that's what the desert does. You know, we got to a road that split up here, and I'm trying to figure out which direction, you know, we want to head. I don't know where that goes other than I see it going up across through that valley. Now there's the mine up there, and if our history has been accurate, the ruins are normally near the mine. Look how beautiful that is though, man. But you know, we've come up another, there looks like another old dump. I don't know if it's a campsite of old times or, you know, miners were up here. I'm not sure. I see a mine up on that hill. And also, you know, we came to a fork in the road. And there's a lot of trash. Some of it modern, a little more modern. I don't know what the purpose of any of this. Now, this was an old dump here, so I don't know if people camped here for years in here or miners were in here. Metal trash. And I tell you why it intrigues me though is where did that road go? I bet there's another old mine up there, so we might just take a little bit of a hike. I'm gonna grab another water and make sure I got plenty of water. We're not going that far, but again, I'm not gonna break my own rules and make sure that we got enough water. And let's take a walk. Let's get out there and see. At least I want to see that old mine up there. And then this is kind of funny here. You know, something was up here. They wouldn't have put that post in there. I got my sidearm. So why would I get my sidearm now when I didn't have it when I went up there? Well, my thinking is, and there is a mine up there. I didn't get to that point. I'm okay with that. Right up there. Now I'm going to a mine up here, okay? Now, if I would happen to encounter an animal, say a mountain lion or a bobcat, for example, and they had a place to run, they probably would. But what if they didn't? What if you got up in that mine and they felt trapped? You know, they not may not feel like they have an option, and that's what we don't want to do. When it's open and clear, I'm pretty good with it. Now, I will tell you something that just happened to me. I wish I'd had the camera on. I didn't see it, but I heard what sounded like an entire hive of bees fly. And I have run into packs or whatever you want to call that. Maybe they're moving their hive. I tell you what, it freaked me out a little bit because when you think about stuff that scares you, you know, I know one thing, whether I got a gun and if there's an animal or animals or people or whatever, you know, I'm not going to shoot bees. And if I got hit with a bunch of bees, that would be a scary ass deal. Now, I will say one thing. The vegetation is absolutely thick and unbelievable. There could be animals all over in this area. We're going to see what's up here, regardless. And but I'm thinking maybe, I'm wondering if we should have went the other way. I tried that other hike. Well, the guys in the ATVs got a lot farther than I thought they were going to be real honest with you. Actually pretty impressive. But coming up here now, and that was a pretty steep climb coming out of there for sure. So let's take a look. You can see, as I'm seeing when we come through here, what we're getting into. Well, dang it. It's covered up. Let's see if there's a hole up there. Maybe somebody had got back in. As you can see up there, the core, there's what they've been hitting right there in that green. So, you know, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up and take a look at that. What they were working all through here. We're gonna try not to bust our butt. Make sure there's no snakes in here. There's the vein. Look at that, isn't that incredible? That is absolutely incredible. Look how beautiful that rock is. That is really neat. Now, we would never found this unless we would have made the journey up that hill, would we? I didn't know what we were dealing with. But they definitely been working stuff out here. Took this whole hill out of here. I don't know if there was a mine on top of this or not. We're gonna take a look and see. Climb up in here. Make sure there's no snakes and no bees and no rocks ready to fall off. And look how they worked that so we can't get our way and make our way up here. With our slick shoes. Looky there. Tell you what, it'll be a little harder coming down. Look at that right there. Isn't that cool? Look at that. Look at that blue. That piece right there. Pretty incredible. Really pretty incredible stuff. Look at that there. Look at that. That's crazy. That vein. I'm guessing that's what they were here for. Pretty cool. Never expected to see this up here. Don't really know what I expected to see, but I don't think it was that. Pretty incredible. That is pretty incredible. That's a hell of a cool find. Didn't expect that. Didn't expect to see that. Pretty cool stuff. Pretty neat. Pretty neat deal. That was a neat journey right there. That was pretty cool. Just, you never know what you're gonna run into out here. You know, it's just absolutely unbelievable. And, you know, it's all a journey. I mean, to find stuff that you haven't seen before. I mean, it's all cool. I saw Mr. Roadrunner coming in the same spot. So this is his house down here. And trying to see if we can figure out where the other set of ruins is. We found two mines so far, which I'm extremely pleased about. And two sets of ruins. Well, we're gonna take a hike up through this this ridgeline right here and see if we can't find something over here. We know that we have a ruin up on the top. We know there's more ruins here. Not sure exactly where, but we're gonna take a journey down here. I was curious to see how bad this ditch was. Actually, I think it's doable. But am I gonna turn around and get the truck? But you never know on this journey, you never know what you're gonna find. So, the old theory is if you find one, there's more. So we found three over here so far. So what do we look for? Look for another clump, another set of trees. And when you see that stuff, guess what? You're probably gonna find some more ruins. What a beautiful little valley though. So that looks like rock walls, but that can't even be right. We're gonna have to take a look at that. Now look at that wall right there. Isn't that intriguing? You know, whether that was done by sheep herders or, you know, cowboys even. It's a pretty incredible wall. And I don't see what it either protects or guides. And you know, they took it off this ridge right here. I'm trying to see what the purpose of it was. You know, if it was for cows, for example, or sheep, where's the rest of it? That's a hell of a lot of wall. Like, where were they trying to lock whatever in? Why were they trying to separate them out? Wow. I'm probably gonna have to go that way even though I don't want to. Well, here we go. We always end up somehow bushwhacking. What is up with that? And this doesn't look friendly. But if that wall wouldn't have been there, I probably would have had no motivation to climb this. But with that wall there, it's intriguing me that, well, summer is right around the corner. And every time I get over one little peak and think that I'm done, it's a fall summit. And I'm hoping I'm running out of fall summits because I'm running out of energy right now. If that ain't it, I'm not gonna tell you ain't gonna finish because I'm always that stupid. No, that is not a drone shot. That is a hike to the top shot. And I'm not there yet. I got another one, another ridge there. Well, there we are right there. And there's the large ruin I was looking for right there. You know, I thought it was up there, but I wouldn't have been able to see it, you know, if we wouldn't have climbed all the way to this very top. Now look, there's the truck. You can see that. So we have trucked a lot to get to this point. And then again, on the top of that peak, see exactly where the ruins were. Right there, you can see them. I could kind of tell, but I wasn't positive, but we found them. This stuff tries to hide from us, and it's no use. Well, this stuff doesn't seem to get away from us, does it? We seem to be pretty fortunate. Got some strong powers working with us, and we always seem to find what we're looking for. But boy, I tell you what, that was a tough one. That was a hell of a hike to get to a place that we could see them. And you know, that was going to be one of my first places I went. But then again, we wouldn't have seen the wall. So we're going to go to the top of this hill, not there, and make our way back down to those ruins. You know, I came down off that mountain right there because it looked like this way was going to be a lot easier. And then I saw another one of these walls that came through here and all the way across. But then look what I saw. Look at those petroglyphs right there on that rock. Well, and here's more here. So how cool is that? That we would find petroglyphs up here on this ledge. That is unbelievable. And there's a fence that went along this ridge line. So if you've got different cultures, different time frames, it's just neat to me that they both were able to use what material they had. Look at that. You know what makes that special is the rocks they put it on. And then that fence goes, this wall runs all the way along that. You know, these are probably not even as close to being, you know, the strongest petroglyph I've ever seen. But, I mean, where they're at and where they're located and along this fence, because all of a sudden along this ridge line, I look down here and I see that, okay, they're working these rocks here, and I'm thinking that these are the original rocks, and then they built this wall around them. And I've seen this same work over there on what I call Facebook ruins. So I've seen this very work where they've used other rocks that were already there. But I find it fascinating that there's petroglyphs up here on these rocks by this old stone wall. You know, this ended up being a fabulous, fascinating day today. I mean, I didn't plan on going all the way down this way, but I'm intrigued by this wall. I'm intrigued that the wall continues to go on and on and on. Fascinating, fascinating stuff. This is, you know, I never saw this wall on Google Earth. That's one thing I can tell you. I never saw it on Google Earth. I think we're about ready to run out of wall, because right now the cliff is going to do the work, so they didn't have to go any farther. Get back into this terrible soil I hate. These flowers, how beautiful are these flowers? Unreal. Kind of go around this side, you see some walls. This thing was massive. And everywhere you walk, just millions of people, let's go to millions, let's not say thousands, there are millions of shards everywhere. You know, if you want to take your time and kind of look through some of the stuff, you probably find some, I mean, you see some pieces popping up here or there. Kind of look poly. Now let's talk a little bit why I'm up here, and we're going to go through this. The Agua Fria tradition. Now they call it the Agua Fria tradition because there was multiple cultures up here. There wasn't just one group. There were multiple groups from multiple places. And so they lived on the corners of these mesas, and they exchanged and got along. I mean, they had to. And I'm sure that at times they didn't always get along, but it seems like they were more taking all the outsiders and trying to keep them out. But if you were in, you were in. And so on every point of these mesas, There is a group of people just like this. And they almost seem to defend each other. And that's why I wonder, there are multiple, what they call forts out here. There's one exactly right over here as well. It's silver, called Fort Silver. And that's whole purpose of that place was that if they got attacked, they would go to that point that they had fortified. And that's how they would withstand it. So I'm wondering if that one could be the same. This looks like an area of some walls right here, outer walls, not walls that maybe a protection, because we're kind of getting more into a courtyard. Now, if you see all this stuff, we were up on this ridge of this hill. that was that grouping. And now there's another grouping here. Another group. Now look how the structure is. Look at the weeds. There's our famous tree that's in every one of them. And they start all over again. And these are massive walls here. This is a big one right here. This is big. This was a big, big operation. And the weeds themselves will probably help protect this. So there's the first section up there. And then this is the bottom section here. And then there are more sections down that hill. This was a very, very large location here. Man, it goes down this whole ridgeline. All the way through. Imagine what it'd be like to live here. I mean, the view would be spectacular. Oh my gosh, look at that piece. Look at that chart. That's the real deal right there. Look at that. Wow. You know, if you want to spend the time, you'd find as much stuff as you wanted to. We'll look up this ridge a little bit right up here just to see if we can see in, see if the structure continued to go, how far. Wow, it just keeps going and going and going. You know, what a view. There's the truck down there, so you can kind of see the road. Somebody is throwing a bunch of stuff up here. Those aren't too impressive. Better impressive pieces on the ground, which that's where they should stay. If you see a piece, pick it up, look at it, but leave it where it lays. What a great, great location, man. How beautiful is this? How unreal. Regrettably, people used to drive up here. Yes, they did. I used to drive up here. Well, we can't do anything about the past except preserve it. But what we can do is protect the future. You know, I'm so stoked. We had a great adventure today. We saw a lot of stuff. Saw a couple areas where they mined. We saw three ruins. We had an excellent journey today. Met some pretty cool people along the way. Got saw a rattlesnake. Man, I'd say that's a full day, right? Hey, wouldn't you say that was a full day? I'd say that's a full day. Do me a favor, if you'd like to help us on this journey, just buy gas. Please donate to Patreon if you'd like to support the channel. If you can't afford to do it, I'd get it. What you can do, though, is you can subscribe. And you can rate, and you can hit that notification bell. And you can put us on Facebook. You can share our stuff. And you know what? I'd appreciate that more than you'd ever imagine. And for those that are donating, man, you made this possible today, and I appreciate it. I appreciate it. As I'm walking down here, getting one more look, seeing some mounds that are not natural. I don't know what they did with them, but those aren't natural mounds. You get to a point where you start to be able to see that, you know, what it is, I don't know, but it's something. That's not natural, a natural area. So, man, look at that. There's shards all the way down this road. Have a great day, man. Keep on trekking. Okay, it's gonna get warm. Water, hydrate. Get enough salt. Don't leave the truck without telling somebody where you're at. Let somebody know where you're at. Jay Shrek, Black Flag Expeditions. Woo! That was a terrible woo, wasn't it? That sucked. I'm sorry about that. I'll try never to do that again. Wow. What a day today.